In today's session, let us check for some other commands with the library and what are our database files, what are the different variety of files, how to create those, and also check other commands with the library.
So you already know why we need library. CRTLIB for create library. While we got the pub 400 access, IBM already created our library. We have seen it in the previous session. If anyone haven't seen the previous session, please start from one after the other as per the serial number so that you could understand the concepts clearly. Let us go back to the topic. I don't think I have authority to create the library. Let me type the command on the command line and check. See, it says you have no authority to create. Let me check for DLTLIB, which is for delete library. Now it is asking for what library to delete. If I give my library name, it may delete. But I don't want to do that because I don't have authority to create the library. And my user profile gets messed up. I suggest you also don't even try this command. So I'm hitting F3. Now in main menu, then the next one is DSPLIB for display library. It displays all the libraries, including the system libraries. Then CLRLIB to clear, which means remove all the content from the library. Why we need this command? In real time, we may use multiple libraries and eventually adds up and takes the storage space. Then we will get request from system admins to clear the unused or the duplicate content, if any. On that, we have to remove the content first from the unnecessary library and then delete the library. Add LIBLE, add library list entry. I will be adding my library M2K train 1. Look at here. I got a message, library M2K train 1 added to library list. Next, I will try DSPLIBL to check how my library added to the list. Before trying to RMVLIBLE, because if I try that, it will remove the library which I was previously added. So I just wanted to type in DSPLIBL to see my library M2K train added as a user, means USR library. Earlier it was added as the current library. To try the next command, instead of type in again and again, we can use F9 to retrieve the previous commands one after the other. Now I am going to change the DSPLIBLE command as RMVLIBLE. Now got the message as library removed. Let's check the library list once again with the command DSPLIBLE. If my user library removed from the list with the previous command, user library M2K train removed, but M2K train 1 current library is still there. Pub 400 adding our library list automatically along with our signing on to the AS400. In real time, that would not be like that. We have to add our library as a current library to make it as a default for object creations when we compile. So in real time, programmer has to use the command change CURLIB to change their library as current library like this. Next, just wanted to give you clear understanding on the main commands for files and programs. For create, we use CRT. For file, the abbreviation is F. for physical file PF, for logical file LF, for display file DSPF, means our user entry screen. We use STR SDA to enter into that utility. For printer file PRTF, means for reports, we use STR RLU, report layout utility. All these are files. Remember this, this is an interview tip. Then for control language program, CLP PGM, for COBOL program, CBL PGM, for RPG program, RPG PGM, then just add the abbreviation CRT or DLT to the item abbreviation to get the command, like CRTPF, CRTLF, CRTDSPF, CRTCLPGM, just like that. We also use other verbs like CHG for change, display, start, work with, etc. But these are main for the files and the libraries. Then let's go to the database. In AS400, DB2400 is the database. In AS400, everything ends with 400. DB2 used in some other systems like a mainframe, but the database here called DB2400. Little bit of changes in the concepts. It is a relational database. So what is RDBMS? An RDBMS is a type of database management system that stores data in a row-based table structure which connects related data elements. Other RDBMS are like Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, etc. The relational database used for complex data analysis and operations. DB2400 has physical files and logical files. Physical files occupies memory, whereas logicals doesn't need memory, as that shows data from its physical file. Name itself clearly explains it, right? Logical file loads the data in the runtime and it has access path, means it sorts out based on the key field. Physical file contains one record format, whereas logical file contains up to 32 record formats. Physical file can exist without logical file, whereas logical file cannot exist without physical file, as it depends on physical file for the structure and the data. If there is one or more logical files for the physical file cannot be deleted until we delete the logical file, whereas logical file can be deleted without deleting the physical file. If you try to delete physical file, it gives error message that it cannot be deleted. Then we check with the command DSPDBR, display database relations, for that particular file, and understand what are all the logical files related to that physical file. Then we can remove all the logical files first before attempting to delete the physical file. So this is pretty important concept, this whole table, for the interview purpose as well.
So finally, please like, share and subscribe. Let us meet in the next video.